Hello, this is a quick explanation of the yeast practice management guidelines covering stress ulcer prophylaxis. It was published in 2008. The authors of the guideline are down in the left lower hand corner there. Level 1 recommendations were give stress ulcer prophylaxis to all patients with mechanical ventilation, coagulopathy, traumatic brain injury, or major burn, which was not defined in the PMG, but in other areas in the literature is defined as greater than 25% body surface area. Also, level 1 recommendation was that H2 blocker was as good as PPI, which was as good as cytoprotective substances such as sucralfate, and also that antacids should not be used as stress ulcer prophylaxis. Moving over to level 2 recommendations, you could consider giving prophylaxis to ICU patients with multi-trauma, sepsis, and acute renal failure. Level 2 recommendations also included the avoidance of aluminum-containing compounds for dialysis patients, and that the duration of prophylaxis should continue during mechanical ventilation or during the patient's ICU stay. Level 3 recommendations were to give prophylaxis to ICU patients with ISS greater than or equal to 15, high-dose steroids, which they defined as greater than 250 milligrams of hydrocortisone per day or equivalent dosing. Also, level 3 recommendation was that enteral feeding alone may be insufficient for prophylaxis, and that the prophylaxis should continue until the patient is able to tolerate enteral nutrition. If you're looking for the full text of this PMG, you can find it at east.org under the Education and then Practice Management Guideline links. This quick PMG minute was brought to you by the East Online Education Committee.